Hello everyone and welcome to the ASMR True Crime Channel. Today I will talk about the case of Christopher Watts, who murdered his family. Please leave your thoughts in the comments and subscribe if you want to stay updated for new ASMR True Crime stories. Christopher Lee Watts and Shannon Catherine Rusick were from North Carolina, Christopher from Spring Lake, and Shannon from Aberdeen. They met in 2010 and were married in Mecklenburg County on November 3rd in 2012. The couple had two daughters, Bella Marie Watts and Celeste Catherine Watts. At the time of her death, Shannon was 15 weeks pregnant with a boy was to be named Nico. The Watts family lived in a 5-bedroom home at Saratoga Trail in Frederick, Colorado, which they bought in 2013. The family declared bankruptcy in 2015. Christopher was employed by Anadarko Petroleum while Shannon worked from home, selling a product called Drive for a multi-level marketing company named Level. At approximately 1:48 a.m. on Monday, August 13th in 2018, Shannon, returning from a business trip to Arizona, was driven home by her friend and colleague Nicole Duft Atkinson. Over that weekend, Chris Watts had been home with their daughters. Later that day, Shannon and the girls were reported missing by Atkinson, who became concerned when Shannon missed a scheduled obstetrics and gynecology appointment and failed to return her text messages. After Shannon missed a business meeting, Atkinson went to the Watts residence at about 12:10 p.m. When the doorbell and knocks went unanswered, Atkinson notified Christopher, who was at work, and called the Frederick Police Department. A Frederick police officer arrived to conduct a welfare check at about 1:40 p.m. During the welfare check, Christopher gave the police officer permission to search the house where the family dog was discovered unharmed, but no sign of Shannon or the girls was found. Searchers discovered Shannon's purse containing her keys and the children's medicine. Her phone was later located between the couch cushions in the family home. Her car, which still contained the girls' car seats, was in the garage. Shannon's wedding ring was found on the bedside table. The FBI and the Colorado Bureau of Investigation joined the investigation the next day. Watts initially told police that he had no idea where his family might be and that he had not seen his wife since 5:15 a.m. the previous day when he left for work. He gave interviews to Denver stations outside the house, pleading for the return of his wife and daughters. Investigators with search dogs could be heard on the property during the interview. Watts was arrested on August 15 in 2018. According to the arrest affidavit and footage from a security camera in the interview room, he failed a polygraph test and subsequently confessed to murdering Shannon. He asked to speak his father before confessing. According to the affidavit, Watts was having an affair and claimed he asked for a separation from Shannon. During the investigation, he claimed Shannon had strangled the girls in response to his request for separation and that he had strangled her in a fit of rage and transported the bodies to a remote oil storage seat leased by his employer, Anadarko Petroleum. Watts was fired by the company on August 15th, the day of his arrest. The authorities located the body bodies were found in crude oil storage tanks while Shannon was buried in a shallow grave nearby. Bella and Celeste's bodies had been purged through a hatch at the top of a different oil tank, with the lid being 8 inches in diameter. According to the medical examiner, Bella had scratches on her left buttock from being shoved through his hole. A tuft of blonde hair was found on the edge of one of these hatches. On August 21st, Watts was charged with 3 counts of first-degree murder, including an additional 1 count per child cited as death of a child who had not yet attained 12 years of age and the defendant was in a position of trust, unlawful termination of a pregnancy, and 3 counts of tampering with a deceased human body. He was denied bail at his first court appearance. At a later hearing, his bail was set at $5 million, with him being required to put down 15% to be released. The case has been connected in the media to the crime of family annihilation. Many of these crimes occur in August before school starts, which may delay detection and investigation. According to former FBI profiler Candace DeLong, cases such as the Watts are rare because family annihilators usually commit suicide after the murders, an action that Watts claimed to have contemplated out of guilt for his actions. In an interview on Dr. Phil, Watts' lawyer claimed that he confessed to killing Shannon after an argument regarding divorce. During the murder, Bella walked in on the couple. Watts then told her that Shannon was sick. He loaded Shannon's body and the girls, without their car seats, into the back seat of his truck. He later smothered the girls one after the other. Watts pled guilty to murders on November 6th. The death penalty was not put forward by the district attorney on the request of Shannon's family, who did not wish for any further death. They were supportive of his decision to accept the plea deal. On November 19th, he was sentenced to 5 life sentences, 3 consecutive and 2 concurrent, without the possibility of parole. He received an additional 48 years for the unlawful termination of Shannon's pregnancy and 36 years for 3 charges of tampering with a deceased body. His sentence began immediately. On November 3rd, 2018, Watts was moved to an out-of-state location due to security concerns. On December 5th, he arrived at Dodge Correctional Institution, a maximum security prison in Waupun, Wisconsin, to continue serving his life sentences. So if I summarize this case, Christopher Lee Watts murdered his pregnant wife, Shannon, who was 34 at the time, by strangulation, and their 2 children, Bella, who was 4 years old, and Celeste, who was 3 years old, by smothering them. He buried Shannon in a shallow grave near an oil storage facility and dumped his children's body into crude oil tanks. Watts initially maintained his innocence in his family disappearance, but was arrested on August 15th after So guys, this was another ASMR true crime story. If you like it, please like this video and subscribe for more stories. Thank you so much.